everyone, welcome to another Friday Focus video. Today is the third card in my wedding card series, and I'm starting out with some taffy cardstock. This is from Basil, and I'm using the mini scoring board from Martha Stewart Crafts. I love this little scoring board because it fits on my work surface just a little bit better than the larger one. It does come with a bone folder up here at the top that you can use, but I'm just so used to using a stylus, I'm just going to continue to use that. So I'm going to score it at 4 1/4. And I actually have marks here for like, let me take the bone folder off so you can see. For an A2 card right there, it's marked right there. So there's your 4 1/4. All right, and I have some patterned paper here. This patterned paper is from, where did it go? A 6x6 pad from My Mind's Eye. This is the Cowboy 6x6 pad. I believe this is only available at Michael's. That's where I picked up mine. But this is the only paper I'm going to be using from it. So I'm going to adhere this down to my card front. And I have been using the ThermoWeb Sticky Dot Runner for a while. But now I'm back to the Glue Glider Pro. I think this is the winner out of the few adhesives that I've tried recently. So I'm just adhering this onto the center of the card. Then I'm going to be doing some die cutting. All right, so we have my Big Shot machine, and I have these two Movers and Shapers dies from Tim Holtz and Sizzix. And the thing with these is you have to have this little metal tray so that they'll kind of magnet in place so they're not going to slide around. And what I have planned is I want to have the hearts kind of placed like this. I want one right there. And one kind of right there. So in order to kind of keep these in place, I'm going to do a little of this and hope that they don't move too much. Lovely. And then I have those, both of those hearts I cut out of the card. All right, I have a couple little pieces here in the center that, because I didn't adhere them straight down onto the card, that they want to kind of pull up. So I'm just adding a little bit of adhesive. I use the Hearts of Plenty die for My Favorite Things, and I cut out some additional hearts. So I have another little heart right there. I'm going to do some layering on it. Now these papers that I've cut out from here, these are from the, My Mind's Eye Follow Your Heart collection that came out last winter. I thought it'd be fun just to have a little grouping of hearts. I'm using foam adhesive to adhere these. I'm wrapping some ribbon around the card. I don't believe that they sell this anymore, but it was from Stampin' Up! At the time when I bought it. All right, I'm using a Close to Cocoa marker from Stampin' Up, and I'm going to add some stitching lines just for added detail. With simple cards like this, stitching lines is a way to add detail without adding more elements to the card. For the sentiment, I'm using this stamp set from Hero Arts. I'm just going to use the one that says love. Using Daffodil Hero Arts layering paper and Daffodil Delight Stampin' Up! Classic ink. Just a really subtle tone on tone. All right, and I want it to come over right here and have it come off the edge of that heart. I'm going to give it a little bit of a ribbon edge. Just like that. And I'm going to turn this over. And with my X-Acto knife, I'm just going to carefully cut the edge of the heart. All right, and that's the card for today. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching.